It was so awesome to have something to watch and see. What was your biggest takeaway from what you saw yesterday?
Shannon Sharp, takeaway number one. If, in fact, this event raised $20 million for charity, for a COVID-19 charity, then all my hats behind me are off. I take all my hats off to that. Takeaway number two, to Jenny's point, that was the most I've been entertained by live sports since that last night of the NBA, and it was a sight for sore eyes, and I just congratulate all four participants, and I thank all four for entertaining me for about 5 hours yesterday afternoon. Takeaway number three is my big golf takeaway. If Tom Brady is, as they said, going into the match, an 8 handicap, then I am Tiger Woods. Tom Brady is not an 8 handicap. Tom Brady spent much of the front nine looking like he'd never, ever played golf in his life. He had what's called, if you know golf, he had the shanks. These demons get in your head where every shot either squirts straight right or you try to overcompensate and you just hit pull hooks, out of bounds left, out of bounds right. I've never seen anything quite like it. And Tom Brady, I guess, cannot hit a driver because on a golf course that was playing very long, it's Tiger's home course called the Medalist. And even though Tom and Peyton were playing from a little shorter tees, it was raining, it rained all day. The golf course was playing long. And if you can't hit your driver, you are dead. Because Tom kept trying to hit a 3-wood. He couldn't hit that for to save his life. And then he tried to hit this weird driving iron, and he could mainly get that down the middle a little bit, but it looked like it was going 150 yards. So now we get to hole number 7, and it got so bad he hit another shank out of bounds, another lost ball penalty. Charles Barkley, who is absolutely the worst golfer in the history of the world.
Awful.
Even Charles, doing commentary, jumped all over Tom Brady because Tom could hear him in his ear and said, Tom, he challenged Tom to play Charles. And Charles said, I'm going to give you strokes when we play. And finally, Tom Brady got mad. Finally, Psycho Tom came out. And all of a sudden, as he was hitting his third shot to a par 4. Tom Brady, from about 100 yards with a wedge, hits a shot on which his audio pack flies off, his pants rip at the butt, and the ball flies and flies and flies and hits about 3 feet to the left past the hole, checks up, starts to spin and takes the hill to the right, the break to the right, and snakes right in the cup. It was the shot of the day. Under the circumstances, it's one of the greatest shots I've ever seen in my life under some kind of pressure. And Tom Brady strikes again. Brooks Koepka had bet $100,000 for charity that Tom couldn't make a par on the front nine. Well, obviously, that was a birdie, so that was better than a par. So Brooks Koepka lost that bet. So in the end, Tom Brady then sort of redeemed himself. He made a long eagle putt off a good shot by Phil Mickelson. He had another great shot to a par 3 on 16 that was about 5 feet away. But guess what? Peyton Manning hit a better shot on 16. Peyton Manning outplayed Tom Brady and outclutched Tom Brady all day long. Peyton Manning made 2 long birdie putts on the front nine that gave them their advantage that they hung on to be one up at the end. And on 18, Peyton Manning hit the clutch shot of the day because they're playing alternate shot, and he had to hit the shot to the green, and it was like a 5-iron from, I don't know, 170 or 80 yards. And Peyton Manning, there's lake to the right. Most amateurs find the lake to the right, especially under pressure. Peyton Manning hit a rope. He hits a little hook and hooked it right into the middle of the green. That won the match for them. Then Tiger, as usual, hit a beautiful approach putt, and the match was over. But Peyton Manning won this battle. And the only good news about yesterday was Charles Barkley did report that he saw Tom in the parking lot before the match, running wind sprints and doing exercises for football in the parking lot. So at least Tom Brady did not practice much for this. At least he didn't pull a Tony Romo the way Tony used to just obsess with golf in the offseason, trying to qualify for the U.S. Open to the detriment of his football. So now, Tom, go back to doing what you went to Tampa to do, which is win a Super Bowl.
Well, Skip, I think if I'm not mistaken, I think he tweeted that he had fun doing that, but back to his day job now. And so he's probably a lot better at his day job than he was when he was moonlighting trying to do yesterday. Skip, but way to echo better. What you just said, to raise $20 million for what we have going on in America, that was unbelievable. Because what they did, Skip, they have donated their original purse. And then on top of that, throughout the course, they raised another $10 million. But what I got is that Tiger Woods looked good. Tiger Woods didn't miss a fairway, Skip. If I'm not mistaken, he hit one bad shot. And that was what, I think, the 16th on the par three, because he was farthest away from the pin.
Yeah.
So he hit one bad shot the entire thing. And I get it, Skip. That's his home course. He spends a lot of time. But I thought he drove the ball, Skip, because you know, Skip, he's been struggling a little bit with that driver over the last couple of years. But he looked unbelievable yesterday. He looked extremely relaxed. I like Skip. Maybe golf should do that. Put earpieces in the guy's ears so we can have a little conversation with him going back and forth. Mm-hmm. Peyton got it started early, Skip, because they asked Peyton, well, you know what, Peyton, if you could have a caddy, who would you like to see your caddy? And Peyton was thinking about it. Now, he already thought about this, Skip. He's like, you know what? I thought about having Eli as my caddy. And then I was like, well, maybe I should have Nick Foles. But a thought came to me that was better than both of them. Bill Belichick. So he started the trash talking early, Skip, early and often. But, Skip, it just goes to show. And I agree with you. I was talking to my brother. He's like, there's no way in hell Tom Brady's an 8 handicap. Now, my brother's an avid golfer, Skip. You know he plays all the time. Is. He's about a one
player.
Or a two.
Good player.
So, but he plays golf all the time. He's like, there's no way in hell Tom Brady is an 8 handicap. But that being said, I'm still taking Tom Brady over Charles Barkley. That's what I will do.
Yeah.
Charles is not beating anybody. Anybody that plays golf at least 10 times a year, Charles Barkley can't beat them. Charles is awful. There's no way around that, Skip. But you mentioned that Tom hit that shot. Skip, talking to my brother, the one thing that you shouldn't do when you play golf is to be angry. Tom got angry and holed out.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't see that. The thing that pro golfers can do is that they can correct themselves. They've been doing this like Tom in a game, Skip. If he's high, he's low, Tom Brady can make the necessary adjustments in a game because he's been playing so long. Well, it's hard for Tom to make adjustments on the golf course because he doesn't know. He doesn't play enough to know, like, what am I doing? And you hear Jake, Skip, for the first time, I'm listening because I want to hear Charles, because I know Charles is going to be talking drunk in guys' ear. And I want to hear, you know, the adjustment. JT's like, well, he's pulling out of it too quick. He needs to do this and he needs to do that. Well, Tom Brady doesn't play enough to have that kind of a feel. But, Skip, what I learned yesterday, and I hope the people at home watched yesterday, Tom Brady can make a case he's the greatest football player ever. Peyton Manning is not far behind. But you see how hard it is when great athletes try to go to another sport and look how they look. So let that sink in for a second. Because guess what? Phil and Peyton, if you put cleats and helmets and shoulder pads on them and ask them to go run routes, they're going to look just like Tom Brady and Peyton Manning did on the golf course. So it's not easy. Just because someone is great at one sport, you better stop thinking, oh, he a great athlete. He could have done this. No, he can't. It's not as easy as you think it is. And you saw yesterday, two of the all-time great NFL players. Skip, they look like, and I read my time like I'm trending. Man, they're not any better than what I am. I can do what Peyton and Tom are doing. And that's what you saw. The guys that do this for a living, play golf, they make it look easy, just like Peyton and Tom made playing quarterback look easy.
That is true. Shannon Sharp, I've always told you, golf is the hardest game in the world. It comes and goes inexplicably, and if it goes during a round, it's almost impossible to fix it on the fly. You have to calm down, get away, go to the driving range, maybe have a lesson. You need to get out of your head and out of your body and out of the moment and from under the pressure to fix it. That's why it was remarkable to me that Brady hit any good shots. I don't think if he had played his own ball the whole way, I don't think he would have broken 100 at the Medalist. And somebody said that it was, he shot 106 there at one point. He looked like he's a 100 shooter to me. But in the end, this is why I have so much respect for what Tiger Woods did to golf, starting with that 1997 Masters. Shannon, the point is, Tiger Woods has struggled with his driver since 1997. It's always been his strength and his weakness all at the same time.
Yes.
He never could hit it very straight consistently. Yesterday, and there was some pressure involved, because remember, he had national TV revenge pressure because Phil had beaten him head-to-head in the first exhibition they played last fall in Las Vegas. So there's pride on the line. It's televised nationally. A whole lot of people don't have anything else to do but watch this quote-unquote silly exhibition match yesterday.
Right.
But Tiger Woods did not miss a fairway. And you said he missed one shot. That shot on that par 3 on 16, he was still 20 feet away. It was a decent shot by his standards. It's just that they had hit three sensational shots ahead of him. So obviously he was away. But he still had a makeable birdie putt to me.
Yeah,
that's the best.
True.
Yeah, that's the best I've ever seen Tiger drive it for 18 holes. The best. And Shannon, allow me to say, he looked supremely fit. He looked like he had lost a little weight through the quarantine.
Yes.
His back looked like it was completely flexible and fluid. He had no limitations of movement at all, or limits to his swing. He was hitting long irons just effortlessly. That guy at age 44, he's about a year and a half older than Tom Brady, that guy looked like he has another major or maybe two majors left in that body of his before 50. Again, can he catch Jack? It's 18 to 15 for Tiger. Probably not, you know, highly doubtful. But could he win one or maybe two more? Boy, that guy yesterday looked like he can win a couple of majors to me.
Especially Augusta. Skip, I think his game is best suited for Augusta. I don't know. Maybe the links, Skip, maybe the open links course where he doesn't have to use the driver that much. He can use use fairway woods and things of that nature. So something like that, Skip. But he played he played unbelievable yesterday. But and the reason I say he missed the shot, you don't. If we have a throwing contest, I'm not expecting Phil and Tiger to beat Tom in any of them. If they throw him from 15 yards out, 20 yards, 50 yards out, if they throw the ball into the bucket, I do not expect Tiger and Phil to throw the ball in the bucket before Tom and Peyton throws the ball in the bucket. So that was my only point, Skip. But like you said, and for if you think about it, Skip, and like you said, if Tom would have had to have played his ball for the entirety of the match, yeah, you might have been on course for 100, because the thing is, Skip, we've seen pros lose it and can't get it back. Skip, that's what happened to Greg Norman at the 96 Masters. Skip, he had a six-shot lead, and he blows up because he can't get it back. So you definitely don't expect the guy. How many times do you think Tom plays a year, Skip? 10, 15, maybe? So you expect the guy that plays golf 10, 15 times a year to be able to recognize what he's doing wrong, correct it mid-match, and to fix it. No, that's not going to happen. But it's great to have Tiger and Phil coaching you through it. You know, hit it at this speed. You want to aim it right there. That definitely helps, Gil.
No, I agree. No, it does. Last quick point. You said on the golf course you can't get angry. You can't lose your temper. I got to say, just on my level in my golf game, it helps to get mad if you're focused mad. If you lose it mad, if you just lose all sense, then you're completely cooked. But if you can focus your anger the way Tom did yesterday, it saved his round. That's just my two cents from a distance.
Well, I think Chuck didn't help. I want some of you, Tom. I'm going to give you strokes. And he hits that shot and says, suck it, Chuck.
Yeah, he did.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show, and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed, or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.